Hey everybody, it's the Last Robokai here, and you know what time it is. It's time for the finale of the Brigmore Witches, of Dishonored entirely. It's Daud, the Knife of Dunwall, versus Delilah, the Witch of Brigmore, and it's a fight for, the life of the future Empress. It's a big deal. We're coming down to the wire here, and it's only going to end with one person walking away, and they may not walk away for long afterwards. So, joining me in the big moment.
Hey everybody, it is Cool Guy, and I am really looking forward to this. I still have not seen exactly how this ends. So, this is one of the few times I'm completely blind going into the ending of a game.
And I'm Orv, and the big moment is my baseball nickname.
Okay, you beat me this time, Orv.
Let's just get straight in.
The Brigmores were an ancient family, bankrupted a generation ago. Since then, the manor has housed two street gangs, a smuggling ring, innumerable rats, and the Brigmore witches. I'd always left them alone, but now a painter named Delilah had taken up witchcraft and formed a coven. She was trying something, a ritual. But what kind? The outsider knows. I cannot abide a mystery.
You can certainly stab one, though.
That's one of my favorite things in fantasy is settings where gods are active participants, and whether they're mortal or not in the setting. But it's always especially funny to me in settings like that when someone curses by a god they know specifically, like in person.
Yeah.
Motherfucker, you sure you want to do that?
The outsider has some good lines in this episode too. So yep, it's all for the marbles, and since I'm not trying to run away with as much money as I can, because, well, quite frankly, that's not how high chaos goes. We're buying everything.
I scouted, sir. They've locked the front, and I've seen evidence of snares. Also, maybe it's nothing, but I spotted several statues of the woman Delilah. I don't know what it means, but I thought it was worth mentioning.
It means trouble. Anything else?
They're getting in and out of the house somehow, but I haven't spotted it. Sorry, sir. Best I can do.
Good enough. I'll take it from here.
Thomas is just like, oh my god, thank Christ he said good enough.
Yeah, no, the entirety of this is a really nice level. They really went all out on this one.
Yeah,
I really like these outside areas.
Yeah, the overall look and feel of this level is totally different from anything else that we've seen in the game. So, I mean, I was really impressed with it.
Yeah, they're definitely trying to make it feel like you've stepped into another world. You've stepped into a completely different domain. And One of the favors we got was regarding a butler. So apparently a butler was trying to smuggle some stuff out of Brigmore, something like that. And so we got a note about him trying to get a pickup and perhaps failing. So we got to go try and find out what that's about. The other favor is that we've got another rune slapped in somewhere, and the last one is we've actually got a witch of the coven willing to talk to us and let us know what the hell's going on. So we've bought all three of those, because none of them are really.
Are you equipping Zephyr?
I thought about it and then I decided not to do it because I'm much more likely to get into fights.
I was going to have a ton of fun with it after you said that it like gave you motion sickness last time.
Oh god, you also might have noticed at the beginning there, in the background behind Thomas, there was a little glowy thing. We'll see a little bit more about that soon, but it's always a good mind if you're playing this level is to watch out for the glowy things on the ground, because they're not always nice items.
Yeah,
I'm navigating here.
I've noticed that that in games and with games in general, it's a good idea to watch for glowy things. Oh?
I killed a hound in the yard, and it got straight back up and went for me. I had to crush its skull to be sure.
That's what the glowy things are. They are hell skulls. And if you bother the hound skull when it's inert, it turns into a large hound and tries to kill you. Remember I was talking about how you might not like dogs so much?
I mean,
I think I've talked about it in both of the LPs that I've done with you guys, but dogs in any game are the worst enemy ever.
Well, these ones are alright, but you've got to destroy the skull, and the skulls are very easily destroyed if they're not aware of you.
Reminds me of wire wolves from 40K.
That was kind of satisfying to see. Just a Brigmore witch getting her shit pushed in. Yeah, I'm okay with that.
Well, you're going to be seeing a lot of that because, aside from the hounds, they are the only enemy.
Well, yeah, I'm just really annoyed at how much of a problem they were for me in the last level because I was having to be gentle.
I hope everything is in order, sir.
So that's that favor done, and I just feel like I can keep opening and closing this box forever, but I won't.
It's a pretty sexy looking box.
It is. I like that box. It's very professional.
Line me with velvet like one of your French girls.
That kind of sounds like a Dr. Weird comment from frickin' Aqua Teen Hunger Force.
A little bit.
Alright, so we'll put on Void Gaze because there's a lot of things that are, you know, we're going to be wandering around. It's actually really difficult to see at this level. There's so much foliage, so many tree trunks and everything. It's not as simple as being able to lean around a corner. So Void Gaze actually comes in pretty handy here.
Yeah, the one practice run I've done of this so far, and it's only gotten me around the exterior as of the time of this recording. I was actually surprised at exactly how difficult it was to navigate, you know, one of the only brightly lit levels in the game, simply because there are so many times where, you know, you lean around a corner and it's just tree, massive tree, all up in your business.
Trees are jerks. As we will learn in this episode, there is an amazing trees are jerks moment in this Let's Play.
Yeah,
don't even mess around, Daud, just like right through the hand, right through the skull. As you can see, some of these Brigmore witches are getting quite long in the tooth.
The look on her face was what really sold it to me. It was like, oh god. That's seriously the first stun mine you've ever picked up.
Yeah, I don't know, just, I didn't get the one in the Coldridge prison, so. Hey! I didn't do the favor for that. So there's a few ways you can enter the place in. I'm going to go with the favor. The hole in the fence. That's the other part of the favor that got us the toolkit on top of the building, I believe. Also procured for us a hole in the fence.
Boy, a lot of these whale oil canisters around would be an awful pity if something were to happen to them.
It is a little odd they're out there, but I guess that's just in case you get you know, hounds and stuff in your area and you just want to blow them up.
There's also a number of other strategically placed oil canisters around here as well, because this place is like, lousy as hell with traps. I mean, that's again, one of the unique design, one of the unique design aspects that shows up in this level is that there's just so many damn, like, deliberately set booby traps.
Mm. Yeah, they know you're coming. They're waiting for you to appear at this juncture. Like, even if you're as stealthy as heck, I think Delilah knows you're coming, and she does not want you interrupting what she's doing, because it's like, this is the most critical moment for her, as it often is for villains.
When does the hero always show up? At the last possible moment. The bane of every mustache twirler in existence.
Though you wouldn't tell Delilah she had a mustache to her face.
Meh, I mean, you don't necessarily need a physical mustache to be twirling it. I mean, she's done a pretty good job of twirling her metaphorical mustache up to this point. All of her, like...
Well,
like,
you know, if you told her she was a mustache-twirling villain, she would tell you she was not, and that she was merely taking what was rightfully hers.
Yeah.
Figurative mustache is my fish cover band.
Also, entitlement complexes are a are a big hallmark of many different villains, both real and imagined.
Yeah, the entitlement complex is the apartment where I'm going to be living.
Fantastic.
Yeah, so mostly out the back here is a few things we can take care of, but mostly we're going to be trying to sort of not get seen for a little bit. I mentioned the statues at the beginning. They come into play here. So get ready to see what that's all about later on.
Those are kind of creepy.
And there's the red jacket witch.
What up?
She's seen us, I guess, or she's gonna go stand at the assigned place now that we've hit a trigger. And so she's gonna slide off into the distance, and I'm gonna go talk to her. God, the ambiance in this level is pretty good. You know, like out the front, mm-hmm. All you can hear is like the frogs and things like that. You know, because it's such a swampy land. And then you've got out the back here, you hear all the creaking, falling rubble, and everything of the buildings. They got the sound direction just right.
Yeah, I mean it's kind of a cliche about how DLC is afterthought or whatever, but that is so not the case in all of Dishonored stuff. They put a huge amount of thought and love into this.
Understood. What have you got?
When her ritual's done, Emily Caldwin's mind will be gone, and Delilah will look out through her eyes the rest of her life.
And Delilah will rule as Empress.
That's up to you. I've got my money. That's all I need.
Wait, what about a way in?
Use the crypt. There's a lever that opens one of the tombs. The lever is kept in the shed. That's all I can tell you.
And that's where the other shoe drops. And also, that's
I'm
where
okay
the
with that.
The witch drops. Don't tell
what
me I can't
get?
Kill everybody in the building. Fuck you. Anyway.
I mean, she basically signed her own death warrant at this point.
Yeah, High Chaos Daud is probably not the person you trust. Although I have been fairly trustworthy to a few people.
Well, it's not just that. It's a matter of yeah. Hey, don't kill anybody but Delilah. It's just like F you. I do what I want.
I appreciate that your compulsion still has you collecting things.
Well, you know, there are actually a few things I want to like sort of get my arsenal built up. Okay. Come back for the explosive bolts. I like at least
oh,
when you just sell these things.
Oh yeah. So there's what I was talking about as far as nasty booby traps.
Mm. Yeah. They've got this place rigged to explode the hell out of you. So now we know of two ways to get into the building. There is a front door, and there is a secret grave entrance in the cemetery, which is nice. We're heading off to the waterfall now, which is where the butler was going to go hide and wait for the smuggler. So we're going to see what became of him now. Love this level. Well, I love and hate this level in equal measure.
I'd like to see a Elder Scrolls game in this art style, just up-resed.
That would be interesting, but I'm not exactly sure how you would Bethesda would manage to get the level of pathing detail that they have set up with this game without basically turning it into a geological timescale problem. Oh lord, there are so many witches around this area.
Yeah, and that statue. If you get spotted by the Delilah statues, she whispers your name. And she summons more witches.
Because of course she does.
Witches get stitches.
Yeah. She's a witch snitch. basically.
Unfortunately, I haven't figured out any way to disable those statues. Even blowing them up doesn't help.
Yeah, I was wondering about that. I think they're just an avoid scenario.
Right. I mean, you can use bend time because the statues need to see you in like real time, as it were. But yeah, that's pretty. That's the only. Jeez, Louise, just going straight through everybody's skull here. Okay, at least that one was different.
What might this be?
What might this be, she says.
Nothing, don't worry about it.
As That's the cool. river crust completely loses its mind.
Yeah, there is one thing I noticed in the credits about this, about like this particular DLC. They had 3 playtesters.
Mm-hmm.
That's gonna come into play.
Really?
Mm-hmm. you might already see it coming into play every so often.
Yeah.
Where I just move somewhere and just start vibrating wildly.
Wong, wong, wong. That's why I was giggling earlier, actually. I saw you just like threatening to clip through the floor.
Yeah, so that favorite was completely redundant, but it can be handy if you want to just, you know, completely avoid fighting anybody.
It's also only like 50 coins, so who cares at this point?
Yeah, whatever. I got all the explosive bolts I need to deal with all the witches. Yeah, at this point, money is mostly just for the if you're trying to escape achievement.
Coin to disappear.
Yeah, which I haven't done ever because. Well, you know, like, compulsive.
Yeah,
compulsive,
I mean,
buyer.
You need 10,000 coins to trigger that achievement. And between Knife of Dunwall and Brigmore, which is, I was looking this up, I believe it's something like 13 or 14,000 coins. So you can spend a very small number of coins on things. It sounds like 3,000 coins is a lot, but you can end up spending that much just on favors. And reminder, you know, the game outright expects you to buy certain things like stun mines and so forth, and like there's only 2 of those to pick up anywhere. On-site procurement just simply doesn't work the way it did in Dishonored. Hi.
I grow sick of this assassin. I was like, wow, you're awfully calm about this.
Yeah, for a second there, I thought she was talking to me, but it's like, oh no, she's talking to the person who was outside of my view on the side.
Hounds will warn us, or the statues, and then we'll descend on him like a murder of crows, and we'll pick his bones clean.
Not an unkindness of ravens.
I'm sure you will. Gotta get one of those in.
Yep. I can't go without the wrist bow kill.
Yeah, I never, like, after using it heaps in the first DLC, I just plain stopped using it because everyone just keeps teleporting too much. Bunch of teleporting jerks. I was wondering if that was a new one or an old one, and it's a new one.
And up! Okay, managed
so,
to climb it.
Of course, not even necessary to track this one down and kill her, but why wouldn't I?
I mean, she's right there. Basically,
it's
like,
on my
throwing
way.
Steak
there's
in
a,
front
there's
of
a bunch
of my
here that I'm probably not going to equip. I actually miss one of the corrupted bone charms before the end of this, so. Hey!
Yeah. At this point, I think we'll forgive you. We've spent this entire game being completionists, so.
So, up here are a few little interesting things. One of which is, this is possibly the place where because I think earlier in the level we got some notes about some overseers coming here to do some investigation to see if there was some heresy going on. This is our Granny Rags recipe for the thing. Dreary Roy's Hissing Daughters, 3 green shells, drink, gulp, swallow. Basically what she's asking us to do is to, drink, like, to put 3 crust pearls into my mouth and, like, drink from the fountain and swallow them.
Gross. I mean, like, yeah. Like, there's, I've had escargot, but this is some crazy stuff I ain't even ever heard of.
Those things are like the size of a baby's head.
Yeah, that's what's really sort of disconcerting about it all. So let's go do that.
I appreciated that the note characterized them as marbles. Like, I've played marbles before, and that's not a marble. Oh, hey, it's like an overseer and hound pair. Great.
Yeah. I give that one a wide berth, because I'm just, like,
I'm like, I don't really want to get into a fight with one and one, because that seems like a really shitty combination to have to deal with, a hound and a witch. Now, I don't know if a statue summoned them, or if something else summoned them, but there are now some more witches here. But that's not the thing I have to deal with here. I'm like, okay, alright. See, this is when I hate, like, there's too much foliage.
Show yourself, little toad.
Man, are all of the Brigmore witches, like, weirdly manic, like, alternately manic and depressive like that? Or manic and angry? I don't know the words to use here.
Possibly. And then I'm like, yeah, alright, let's get going here. And,
Dream!
Oh no. Oh no. You might notice there wasn't the sound of me hitting the ground at all. Yeah, I'm floating.
You're just floating. Awesome.
So, three playtesters.
Three playtesters indeed.
That's not a knock against them. You're only going to be able to find so much, but that's yeah.
I mean,
so,
yeah.
Who's ready for man versus tree?
Oh my god, Robokai.
Look.
Losing so far.
Listen.
Oh boy.
Sounded okay, like, I'm out. And then I think I got projected into the sky because I built up momentum. I think that's how that works.
Not like the greasiest fart ever.
So yeah, there we go.
Anyway, from when I was messing around, it kind of seems like the game basically has just like a concept of how many witches reinforcements that they have, and anytime the number of witches around like dips below that, it figures out where to spawn reinforcements. You can eventually deplete them, but it takes a while. Good night.
That's a whole lot of dead witch. Right, let's go have a drink.
Yeah, no, let's just choke down three pearls, because why not? What the hell?
Because why not?
That is the...
There we go.
That is the most bizarre thing.
Granny Rags always asks you to do strange stuff, and I quite appreciate it. So I'm like, okay, well, I've pretty much got everything I need, so... Bugger it. Let's actually buy Bloodthirsty.
Yay!
I do have a little bit of a think about this. I'm like, yeah, what the fuck ever. Let's do this. Let's get silly. So I just read through it here so I know what's going on as well, because I've never used this power before.
I've got like 100 hours logged on this game on Steam, and I've literally never used Bloodthirsty.
That's good. Here's the first time for me. So I need to go head to the graveyard now. This isn't the optimal route, ladies and gentlemen. There, I'm gonna be backtracking the hell out of this place.
I was gonna say, like, oh, incidentally, God, do you know where the key to that locked door is? it's about 10 feet away from the door on the interior side, the one that you were just on. It's just in a corner, so it's really difficult to see.
I don't know why this isn't activating. This is, the terrain here, like, I don't know. Maybe
the,
I'm just.
I actually had bad times. Yeah, no, I actually had a pretty good idea of what that was. The terraces or overhangs or whatever the heck the word is supposed to be there. The collision meshes for that do not quite. Link up with the texture, which makes a lot of sense from a performance and programming perspective, because you can just use rectangles or whatever, but it does end up in a couple of like weird things like you're seeing.
Knife.
Yeah, no, this is gonna happen. Oh, for...
Hey,
you just lost your privileges for yelling at me for whiffing in the next video.
No, he has not.
Really,
even
really
in
haven't.
Slightest.
That was like that was like I've whiffed plenty of drop assassinations, but I nailed the only one that mattered, and that was off the top of the Empress's statue.
Yeah, okay. You do have that going for you. Yes.
Whereas
I'm gonna give you shit about whiffing in the next LP.
Yeah, I'm okay with that. You know, whatever. There's a comment in the Low Chaos Dead Eels that I need to start wearing a cup to these because you guys bust my balls so much. My response was, oh, don't worry, old habits from fencing.
It's fucked up.
Dude, I mean, fencing is not exactly a full contact sport, but there still are people waving around metal sticks. You don't want to get your junk involved in that.
Mm-hmm.
Women wear chest plates as well.
Yes, for some of us, it's not merely a fetish, it's a way of life and a culture. Let's repair the switch. This is a very intense decision here.
Yes.
Just in case you came via the other way. I'm like, oh yeah, right, I gotta operate it. Let's just sit here. Hello, dog.
Hey, dog.
Bye, dog.
Wow.
Speaking of Elder Scrolls.
And make the weirdest noises. I like it, it's very unsettling.
Rat.
Mexican rat off.
I want to get over this. I could probably have slid under it, but you know, whatever.
Yeah, that was probably the most efficient way to do things. But your way worked really well, actually. I was afraid you were going to try to blink through it, which would have triggered the crap out of it. Yeah. Hi.
Yeah, so this is what happens when the statue sees you. You didn't see it, but she basically just goes, FREAKY POSE!
Yeah, no,
and,
I saw it.
Everyone
like,
spawns
well...
in an area nowhere near me, so it's completely a waste of... Yeah, they're not even downstairs, they've teleported upstairs.
Man, the,
so, yeah,
the musical
nice.
Sting was pretty cool, though.
Oh, yeah. Another good sound direction piece. Imagine the first time that happens to you in the game, you're kind of like, ooh.
The first time it happened to me when I was rehearsing, I got a literal like shiver down my spine. Like my entire body had a shudder. It was a pretty cool experience.
And I thought the photo district was run down.
Yeah, we are now inside of we're inside Brigmore Manor now, and it's a mess. It's a maze of fallen down structure and everything like that. I just want to say I really like the fact that the hounds are warming themselves by the fire, just in skull form. That's a little detail that's really, really cool, and I really, really like that about, everything is wrong about this place. You probably noticed that something is very wrong about that corridor, but first...
No, don't make me eat anymore. I can't. Brother Marcus, I denounce the Abbey.
Yeah, so Predcliffe,
I denounce God.
Yeah, well,
Predcliffe,
I mean,
and Brother Marcus went to find this thing, and looks like Predcliffe was forced to eat Marcus. So
yep, that's
a bit of a bummer.
that's pretty hardcore.
And so I notice, that Karnaka is in Sarkonis, so I wasn't wrong. So just reading through that. They're talking about the place and talking about some of the weird things that go on. A little bit more foreshadowing of where we're going to be going. I wonder if this was that they knew at this point this is where they were going to go, or they just had a whole... They had such a really good world built up already.
Daud came out pretty well after the main game, so it's entirely possible.
Daud was also just voiced and presented very well. I'll continue a thought on this after this scene.
They saw the Caldwin girl is the key, the girl in the painting. Where's Delilah?
Now I think she spawns because of him screaming. Bummer, sure.
he dies
shortly afterwards.
Yeah, from what I understand, even if you like nail that woman and bend time, he still expires a few moments afterward. Anyway, typically before a game like this is made, you have like people usually have like multiple novels worth of worth of written lore about a game, just because all of those things end up becoming your design documents for things in the game or so forth. Oh, there she is. Well, so I mean, that's what it always surprises me.
Don't worry, she made that
when like novelizations of specific games come out, and they make some really weird decisions with things, like the Baldur's Gate novelization, like presumed that the main character was a lawful good fighter when they had written all of these tomes of lore about like all of the crap that the ball spawn had done in and after the games.
Okay, I was only half listening to you, and then I heard the Baldur's Gate novelization. Let's take a minute out to talk about the Baldur's Gate novelization.
It's pretty bad.
And how insanely bad they are.
Yeah.
Like, even by the standards of video game novelizations, those things are just such fucking atrocities.
Yeah, they are. They are pretty terrible. Like, almost unforgivable, really.
But is it as bad as Spaceballs, the movie, the book?
Yes. Wow, 1,000 times worse.
I mean, there's a little bit.
Because I actually have read Spaceballs, the movie, the book.
There's a little bit of a difference between Spaceballs, the movie, the book was kind of was like you could obviously tell that the author was just like, this is the biggest piece of junk that I've ever written in my life, but I'm writing it anyway. And then you read the Baldur's Gate novelization, and it's pretty obvious that the author honestly thought he was like trying to do a good job or whatever, and it's just so atrociously bad. It's like almost unreadable. Like
for some reason upgrading to the second bloodthirst level actually puts you in the bloodthirsty zone. I don't really understand it, but if I'd have known that, I'd have probably waited till I was fighting to get a free one.
Yeah. Okay then. Whichever.
Yeah, this place is pretty maze-like.
Yeah, it's like three floors and
and a lot of these places, like these little alcoves up here. Yeah, nothing. I can only assume the witches that teleported down after their conversation, they were up here, and you can use this sort of thing to sort of wait for them to leave. If you're trying to just not even like touch anybody, if you're trying to ghost the hell out of the place, generally stay out of the foyer because.
Dem dogs though.
Those dogs, although they can be stuck up on. Yeah, so this is the point where I noticed the hallway. I'm like, all right then.
somebody was like a Teddy Roosevelt sort of cat up in here, just.
Batenya Bavanitsi Bava, hey.
Daddy, they killed Pumbaa, and he tastes delicious, darling.
I worry intensely about the kind of person that just arrays like animal heads along a corridor like that and goes, yeah, that doesn't look creepy at all. Although when I see it, it reminds me of like the cutscene sequence in XCOM 2 before you go and, you know, when you have to walk down the corridor and everyone's just standing there saluting.
I want to be intimidating to everybody. Yeah, sure, because that's
the at least the heads don't follow you.
Oh my god. Like, it would be just like one of these witches to just be like, yeah, no, that sounds awesome. It sounds like a great way to spend an afternoon. How you doing? Damn.
What?
Good night.
Yeah. So that was the fun of the show when it comes to you know, bloodthirsty. You can just spend it all immediately and.
Man, I just.
Wish everyone
just
would stop kicking me in the face already. Come on.
There you go.
I mean, seriously. Always in the face.
I actually like seeing people kick me in my run of it, because that's the only melee attack I can take without instantly dying.
That's true, that's a shove.
Yeah, or like the shoulder check, that still doesn't hurt very much. You know, I always think that some level designer was having a really good laugh whenever they put like an empty glass in the middle of something like that. because they're just like, okay, the player is gonna be going he's over, just mashing S.
Try and scarf his way through, yeah.
And then he's just going to have this ball crap up in his face.
Speaking of ball crap up in his face. Oh, hey, shit, fuck, nope, you didn't see me. Oh, crap.
Whoa, look at her weave!
I appreciate the attempt.
I freely admit that was the worst attempt to cover for it. Come on. Stop teleporting.
Oh,
then there's
man,
another one. I'm just like, okay,
all right,
we get it. I'm trying to get Bloodthirsty going so I can use the level 2 one. But then it was like, nah, this isn't gonna work. I'm in a really disadvantageous position, if that's even a real word, so... You gotta, like, left-click the thing, that's why I'm swooshing there. And then that.
Sure, okay.
And there's more.
The hell was that?
Hey, that was... That looked like a legit adrenaline kill, but it looked like he was out of range for, some of the more elaborate things to play. God, now it's sitting here trying to tell you how to block in front of a bunch of witches that use primarily ranged attacks.
I mean, you can block the shards.
And there's still more of them!
How many?
Why are they green?
Yeah, I don't know, like, I guess it's like a ritual thing, you know, they wear the earth on them. I guess they're supposed to be like a weird, they were like a weird pagan cult before Delilah came and sort of, you know, actually gave them powers.
That last kill was really cool.
The one where you just, like, you cut her throat and then held her head underwater? Yeah, that was...
Well, no, he ran up a clock and leaped at her.
Oh, okay, that one, yeah.
I have these moments of accidental competence I always enjoy. The game does a good job of making my flailing around like an idiot actually pay off, so that's good. Here's a corridor full of traps.
Yeah, that... Wow. I spotted two others that you haven't hit yet. And that's just with me casually looking around.
Don't worry, we'll
get
deal
there.
With those.
We're making it happen. Okay, fantastic.
It's a really neat rewind effect. During the final moments of the ritual, she's alone. What if something goes wrong? Who will help her? Doesn't it worry you? You under that she's gonna fuck you over?
She's not clever enough to worry about something like that. I can tell you, once Delilah becomes the Empress, the first thing she'd probably be doing is cutting the cord with the rest of them, just the moment before the overseers kick the door in.
I mean, just look in the walls. This place is probably packed with C4, and the moment it works... Forgive me, sister.
You're right. Speaking of C4...
A little sad that didn't work. Okay, so here's something we didn't get to see them do before in the fighting, but yeah, they can summon the blue plants, which swat you around, are generally jerkish.
The
I hate dealing with teleporting enemies. I'm just like, where are you?
Wow, you cleanly missed her, and it still put a shard or two in her back.
It also took a weird time to actually explode.
Yeah, I've noticed that explosive bolts seem to... Oh, okay.
Sorry, now we've come in here, it's just told us where we need to go to get the lantern. You could probably stumble across it exploring before, but there was no indicator for that, so this is where the backtracking comes in.
Well...
Interestingly, we did get a message prior that indicated where it was, but it didn't give us a marker.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ!
I don't give a fuck.
Well, I mean, I was right that those whale oil things were strategically set to be bombs.
Yep. And I'm strategically placed and I don't give a fuck. So this would be the way in, except it's locked, and, yeah, it's locked.
Eh.
That's the exit.
The exterior. You go up to the second floor and turn left, though. That seems to head the right way. Of course, dogs.
Yeah, I'm gonna work it out as I go. I don't want to. Again, I'm trying to avoid that main room. At least we got that disarmed.
I really want to see where Delilah got all of these launchers. And she just goes into some tinkerer's office and is just like throws a sack of money on the table and says, "I'm buying in bulk."
I think it's weird that you think she would buy them.
Well, yeah, I mean,
she probably just appears and goes, "I'm taking these," and then like ties the guy to a wall.
I'm presuming that they're not made, because who the hell leaves like 15 launchers lying around?
Wizards.
That's shotguns,
probably,
dude.
Yeah. The outsider.
No, it's everything.
Just some more of Piero's ramblings.
Okay. Man, I'm just like taking all of this in. Like furiously taking notes in my head.
Yeah, so one of those witches is carrying the chest key. If by chance you didn't get the chest key from the witches from before, like in Coldridge.
Yeah.
So that was the payoff of that. And then we're like, oh, okay, here we go.
It's just a charm on there.
Tank! So this is the opposite of Zephyr. You walk much slower, but you can take a lot more damage.
I have the tank theme from Left 4 Dead playing in my head now.
It's a bit of a weird thing to... A bit of a weird descriptor to use for this because, you know, tanks in Dishonored don't exist in what you would describe as something that can tank damage. You know, so you basically... The implication of having a charm like that would be when you get hit, you violently explode. Because that's the only tanks I can think of in Dishonored.
Yeah, either that or just being a big brewery tank. So when you get hit, you just like randomly spew out beer or something or whiskey.
I just accept it's a video game thing.
That's yes, that is indeed Emily Caldwin.
Here we go. Yep. I will sit in the young lady Emily's like skin and wear her face like a mama's mask.
Wow.
Such a good word. I love that word.
That is quite the description.
Yeah, you can tell she's carrying some baggage.
calling that baggage is like, oh, Christ. To become empress.
In case you missed all the other clues along the way, there it straight out rubs it right directly up your nose, so you don't miss it.
Fugu feast, right?
Some more books of stuff. Doesn't really matter. I like all that.
I do appreciate how the Fugu feast is like something that all of the weirdos in this in this game have a copy of. Like Campbell had a copy of it right in his private quarters. Delilah does, and
his rape dungeon. I think you meant.
Yes, his rape dungeon is what I actually meant. And then, like the.
Are you proposing that the Fugu feast is the lusty Argonian maid of Dishonored?
I thought that was the other ones that we had.
Yeah, that we completely butchered in Dunwall City Trials.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, that's a good point.
What?
Yeah, so them howling does in fact summon witches, but we're in a closed corridor at the moment, so yeah, doesn't quite have the same problems as you might expect previously.
Fantastic. Yeah. My lady does not.
You can't
toss
on the floor and ruin my day that easily.
What?
So. Apparently someone's been pranking the shit out of somebody else.
Oh my god. Tonight I'll close my eyes and pretend to sleep. The worst.
I can figure out who's putting teeth in my shit. What the fuck?
Oh god, no.
The tibia plays. Of course they have a copy of that. This is the lusty Argonian maid.
Yeah.
At least that's in the library, though. Is. Anyway, the other weirdo that I remember having a copy of is the one nymphomaniac Boyle sister. She also had a copy of Fugu Feast. What? Actually, never mind. Yeah, I don't want to know what the hell that book is going on about.
Yeah, that seemed a bit worrying, and I'm still not, like, there are a lot of legends in here about a woman or a hag who does this or that, and I'm like, is this Granny Rags, or is it something even more terrible? Does it just sort of exist out there? You know, like, there's a lot of things to be worried about.
What the hell?
I'm just killing them the old-fashioned way.
No, it's just the way bolts. The skull, like rocketed upward.
Well, there is a little
exploding.
Delay on the bolts when they connect, so basically physics ricocheted them. They were still attached to the bolt, but because, you know, they're an actual object with actual physics.
That was brilliant looking.
Yeah, I liked it. Oh dear, more
witches. Yeah. Wine some more. I can't wait to see how many dead or unconscious bodies found your stats will show.
Oh, it just says all of them.
that's after about 30, the game just gives up and says lots.
It's just an emoji of someone shrugging. It's like, it's you, what do you expect? Like, do you really even care at this point? Why would you even pay attention to that statistic?
And everything.
Alright, so if we were supposed to feel like we were heading into another world with coming to Brigmore Manor, now it's time to really, like, throw away our yeah, I don't even know how that happened. I'm just like, how did you lose all your clothes and get half eaten? Rats, probably.
Yeah, rats were here is my idea.
But yeah, now it's time to actually step into another world.
Enter the paint. Well, that's a great objective marker.
What was the name of this painting?
It is called Where It Opened, I Entered.
Sure, we'll go with that.
And the outsider fucks up.
I have good job, no idiot. Sympathy for this dickhead.
And yet, sir, Delilah's talents are quite different.
I, you know, I'm jealous of you, actually. You can... But it's really easy for you to pretend like you're not listening to this guy.
You think that.
Her will into her subject, whatever it is. We're witnessing her masterpiece, and perhaps yours as well. You
oh, God.
All right, Bugs Bunny.
Ignore that.
Empire. The end is coming. And it's been glorious to watch you throw your will against the machinery you set into motion. All things end. All things burn to ash. But you, my friend, burn bright.
You know, I just got this really acute, like, vision of the one, like, really early Looney Tunes thing with Daffy Duck and Elmer Fudd when he was so-called Egghead, where Daffy Duck just goes flipping out across a lake and then pauses and says, I'm not crazy, I just don't give a darn! That's like literally The Outsider.
Two roads diverged in a wood, and The Outsider was an asshole on both of them.
Alright, so Delilah is getting her painting ready. Now, you can obviously see that there is a non-lethal option here to deal with her. The low chaos version, if you will, but let's be real here. Have we come this far just to, like, trap somebody inside
nice
of a painting?
Once.
Daughter of Jessamine Caldwin, heir to the Empire of the Isles. I call out to you from the void.
I stab you in the neck. But, as they say, you didn't think it was going to be that easy, did you?
Freaking beautiful.
All of those statues turn into,
Delilahs.
Turn into Delilah. And all of them are using their powers, so this becomes very confusing very quickly.
Zoom!
I'm like, oh, for God's sakes.
Get an assassin out here!
Your mom was a witch. She should have told you better.
Wow.
Most rude.
Boom! Oh, come
on!
She was right
why
next
that didn't
to
even
it.
Yeah, I'm sort of sad about that. This is such a confusing fight! I like it, but it's such a confusing fight. Because you're just getting shoved and bounced and swatted, and it's just like, okay, alright.
This, I didn't know that. Whoa, okay, sure.
Yeah, they can grab you too,
that's
by the
cool.
way.
That's cool.
Yeah.
I didn't know that this had turned into a bullet hell. Get a Tuhu in here to help us with Danmaku or something.
I think it's just they damage you as much as you
roll. Oh,
physics!
I don't even understand what just happened. Yes. I'll use your skin.
Okay, so we got one. Finally, we got one of the. I think it was like four to start with, and I.
It seems like her teleporting around is actually causing her to drop aggro on you in places. Because
yeah,
some of her clones are saying, like, searching lines.
Keep saying
she
that to yourself as many times
she's,
as you
she,
need.
She's realized there's a. I'm just listening to her ramble. It's good.
Sure, why not?
Okay. She's not immune to time stop. Alright. So now we've taken
Sucks
care
to
of
be
her.
Her.
Of course, not properly taken care of, but taken care of her. Is, of course, the official way we need to do it.
No! You can't do this! She took my life.
No, that's what we're going to do.
For a moment there, you can still see Dad's like, am I going to have to cut her head off? Am I going to have to cut her head off? All right. Okay.
That was
and I
beautiful.
Love this next touch. This is one of my favorite little moments.
Damn straight you did.
Nice.
I like that. So yeah, not as many people killed as you'd think.
And only 11 bodies found? Man, that's very
you know,
surprising.
only a third.
Know exactly what it took to save Emily Caldwin from a living death as Delilah's puppet. No one except the outsider. Watches everything and thinks his own dark thoughts and speaks to few in any generation. I've learned that our choices always matter. To someone. Somewhere. And sooner or later, in ways we can't always fathom, the consequences come back to us. I came from Sirkonos to Dunwall as a boy. Made my living as a killer. One of the few who've heard the outsider's voice. I murdered an empress, but saved her daughter, who will one day rule the Empire. Those were my choices. I'm ready for what comes. I have one more surprise for you. I ask for my life. When I killed your empress and took her daughter, something broke inside me. Now I want nothing but to leave this city and fade from the memory of those who reside here. I've had enough killing. So my life is in your hands. Make your choice.
You make an eloquent plea for a man with innocent blood on his hands. It's a shame Corvo doesn't know the real story, isn't it? How Daud, the legendary assassin, spent his last days doing whatever it took to save Emily Caldwin. Defied the keepers of Coldridge Prison, faced down gang leaders in the terrors of Brigmore Manor. And with the end coming, you cut a savage swath through Dunwall, blood and terror, for the fate of the Empire, a story never to be told. And you leave the ending up to Corvo. That's courage. You make your own choice and accept the price.
and that shot of the Empress statue as that ends. Mwah!
Yes, very nicely done that. And yeah, that's how High Chaos ends, ladies and gentlemen. For poor old Daud, he manages to accidentally do the right thing and gets exactly what he deserves in the end.
Pretty close. Pretty close.
Yeah, I like that. I think that's obviously not the canonical end, because as they've said, Low Chaos for Corvo is the canon, and obviously in Low Chaos he spares Daud.
Yep.
So.
Yep. I haven't gotten to that point myself, but I don't think that's going to be a particular surprise to anybody, because Daud has shown up in some of the pre-release media for Dishonored 2, hasn't he?
I have not.
Good
seen
job spoiling it.
I have not seen a single sign of him, actually.
Oh, I thought he
no,
had.
I haven't
oh no,
seen
wait.
Him
I'm
it.
Sorry. I'm getting it confused. There was one particular ship captain who looked
yes
suspiciously
kinda
like
Billy
Lurk.
Only I think they're missing an arm or a leg.
Yeah,
but that's not to say Billy couldn't have had an adventure that cost them an arm or a leg at some point.
Right. You know,
Dishonored 2 does take a significant period of time.
15 years. After, 15 years.
Yeah.
Man. One of the things that I would really like to see, one story that I would like to hear told is, like, what was the discussion that was that people had with the artists over how to depict Delilah's art? Because seriously, that is an outrageously unique style. I mean, we could go full art criticism over it if we wanted, but I.
Let's not.
Well, yeah, I don't intend to. The point is that I've really never seen something quite like it, and I'm kind of blown away every time I see one of those incredibly bright and vivid paintings. And it just.
But you can still see a little bit of see a little bit of the Sokolov style in it too. So obviously
yeah.
It's the same artist who's done it, and they've managed to sort of hold to the fact that Delilah is the apprentice painter of Sokolov as
mm-hmm.
well. You can sort of see some similarities in the composition of the piece, but you know what I mean. Yeah, it's by design or by accident, it's still excellent, and it's like they just bind Dunwall together, the people in it. The events in it just so perfectly with Dishonored. I've seen people talk about the setting is not particularly interesting, and to those people I say, you just aren't
paying
dunking
attention.
Yourself headfirst in it. You've just got to immerse yourself completely, drown in it.
Well,
because it is.
I would just straight out say they're not paying attention. Like I was saying, saying earlier, like literally hundreds of pages. Are written as just, you know, stories and writings and, you know, what we would identify as fan fiction before a single line of code on this sort of thing is ever written, because it all becomes design documentation for binding this world together exactly the way that you're talking about. And, you know, I mean, clearly when there is so much detail and so much thought put into this, you're just like, well, it's not very interesting. You're saying one of two things. One, I wasn't paying attention. Two, it's just not my style. And if it's just not your style, okay, that's fine. You know, it's the same way how elves aren't my style. I get that, but that doesn't mean that every story with elves is bad, though most of them are.
Holy declarative statements are bad. Internet, stop making them. That'll ever happen.
Yeah, no, that would require people to have moderation in their speech, and moderation doesn't get you attention.
I just love everything about the world, like Dishonored
mm-hmm.
2, the fact we're going to somewhere else in Dishonored 2, the fact we're going to get to see even more crazy things about this bizarre world, spend more time with, you know, with just everything that's going on. You know, there's going to be overseers again, there's going to be weird sort of events from the past being drawn up to envision Dishonored 2. Like if it's as good as Dishonored 1 in its world building, and it certainly looks like it, it's going to be very fantastic just to play, to be inside, to re-immerse yourself with this entire world.
I cannot wait. I am so looking forward to it. One of the very few few games in the last 12 months that I've pre-ordered. Dishonored 2.
Cinemax has a shit ton more studios than I'd think.
Oh yeah, ZeniMax is actually pretty expansive. Most of it has to do with localization and efforts, but that is an incredibly difficult job. So a 20 to 30 person shop to do a truly professional localization effort is not uncommon.
Yeah, at least they're trying. I don't know what it's like in the other localization versions, but it seems like they've got plenty of people on hand to make it a good one.
Well, and yeah, they've got enough people, and ostensibly these are folks that, you know, have good relationships with the parent company as well. I mean, Synthesis Madrid, I know that I've seen that name before. I can't remember exactly what they've done, but I know that I've seen that name before. And you know, the people that
see three playtests.
Oh God!
You
well,
fucked up, George.
Miss Hart, Miss Hartwig, Mr. Royer,
tree,
and Mr.
Fuckers.
Short, you fought bravely against the inevitable.
But sadly, I found the tree.
Yeah, there's always
at least one idiot who will basically like stumble across the one thing you missed.
Yeah, you can just imagine me giving like, you know, the MGS3 big boss salute to those people because they had the impossible job. Oh my Christ!
And there we have it, that, ladies and gentlemen, that was the Brigmore Witches. And that was Dishonored High Chaos in its entirety.
We've got one more episode, and that'll be me polishing it off next time. And I cannot wait. I am so stoked.
Yeah, it's a heck of a. I would still say, having now done both of them, I like the Low Chaos ending a lot more. So we're gonna see what that's all about. But until then, I've been the Last Robo Kai.
I've been Cool Guy.
And I've been Orv.
And we'll see you all next time in the grand finale for Let's Play Dishonored.